So, Robert, everything you do firsthand. You want to see it, be there, get the firsthand feel for what is going on. You did the same thing with Afghanistan. Just got back. Tell me, what's your 10,000 foot of the place? What should we be concerned about in Afghanistan besides the obvious?
Well, the thing that struck me the most when I first got off the plane was the extraordinary, horrible poverty right next to the militarization of the city and the culture. Literally, it's truly shocking when you first get there. You drive by almost any city block, and there are two or three gunmen standing in front of buildings hired either by embassies or in front of military facilities or ordinary stores and apartment buildings. I drove up to this huge barbed wire over a cement wall, three armed guards, and my friend said, "Oh, this is your hotel." And I thought they were kidding me.
Oh,
and then I did a little video that's online at rethinkafghanistan.com, and that was the hotel. I mean, the security, the poverty, and then the bombed out buildings right next to each other. And you see where the resources are going. The resources are going for militia and military. They're not going to rebuild the country.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you went there because you're going to deliver to us, to the American public, a new film, which we always like getting a new film from you, Robert. So
thank you.
Tell me about your new film.
Well, we're doing a film and a campaign called RethinkAfghanistan.com. But rather than wait till the film is finished, as we complete a section, we're putting it out free online at Rethink Afghanistan. So the first section was about troops. The second was about Pakistan. The third that we're working on right now is the cost of war. So we literally are researching, filming, fundraising all at the same time because these decisions are being made right now. And we want people to have the information. We want them to understand the problems with the military solution, and we want them to push for hearings, Senate hearings, where these questions can get asked. I mean, basic stuff. How many troops? How long? How much will it cost? How do we know when to get out? Mm-hmm. Nobody can answer those mm-hmm. questions.
But we sent 21,000 troops over there in a surge. In defense of Obama on this, I know he's already received a lot of criticism, but in defense of this, he says he needs time to figure this out himself. And you have to at least respect that. I mean, he realizes the economic recovery is going to be threatened by it. It's going to destabilize Pakistan further. It's going to create a rift with European allies. It can't be good for a relationship with the Muslim world. So I think he is thinking about. He's not trying to build empire, I don't think.
Well, I don't accuse him of that. I think he's incredibly smart, brilliant. He's got very smart people around him. I'm just deeply concerned that we sent 21,000 mm-hmm. additional troops. We didn't send 21,000 teachers or doctors. We didn't send money to build hospitals or schools. And, it costs per troop for 1 year, per individual, to support them. It's somewhere, depending on which estimate you use, between $350,000 and $520,000. One troop, 1 year. I mean, just think the possibilities for those resources. Now, I'm with you in that I'm very hopeful he's going to think about it differently. The military solution is not working, and it's not going to work there. But with the problem, the more troops you put in, then you need more troops to support the troops who are already there.
Right. Well, I think, at this point, the economic catastrophe of all of it is something that's got to be weighing on his mind. I think it's clear nobody's thought of an exit strategy. It's almost like an exit strategy, a luxury. It's the same trap that the Soviet Union fell into, the British Empire fell into. There's enough history there to where we certainly shouldn't make the same mistakes. Here's a question that I have. Maybe you can simplify this. Who the hell are we fighting? What is it we're fighting? Who are they? Who are we fighting?
Well, theoretically, we are fighting the terrorists who attacked us on 9/11.
Right.
The problem is, number one, the terrorists were Al-Qaeda. Al-Qaeda's in Pakistan.
Right.
So the fundamentalist, one of the fundamentalist elements in Afghanistan is the Taliban. But the Taliban did not attack us on 9/11.
Mm-hmm.
So what, in fact, are we doing there? And Then the question becomes, okay, if you want to go after terrorists, then how do you do it? Well, I think history is pretty clear that invading countries with troops is not going to get the job done around tracking down some terrible criminals who are terrorists.
Yeah, you've got kind of this ethnic honeycomb over there, don't you? It's almost impossible to get a handle of on and say, well, look, if we send in occupied troops, if we patrol, if we garrison, if we have a military presence, we can control that honeycomb of various ethnic groups and tribes. I just don't. It's the same problem the Soviets had. I mean, if you look at the interviews of the people that came out of the Soviet conflict, they said half the time we didn't know who we were fighting.
Well, exactly. We have in our first video at Rethink Afghanistan a general in the Soviet army who talks and says, you are making the same mistakes we made. Mm-hmm. And you're absolutely right, by the way. There are 273 different tribes in Afghanistan.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very much a tribal culture in which the Taliban comes from one of the most biggest tribes, which is the Pashtun tribe. So it's not, and I happened to be there, by the way, one day I got this amazing footage, 25 members of the Taliban turning their guns in. And I asked them, I said, why? You know, why were you doing it? Why were you fighting? They were fighting from 2 years to 30 years. Mm-hmm. And it was about family. It was about honor. And the Carnegie Report said the single biggest reason for the resurgence of the Taliban in Afghanistan is foreign troops.
Yeah. Look, Robert, let's take a quick break. We're going to be right back.